electric flux. Generally, the group of lines of forces passing through any area is called electric flux. The number of lines of forces passing through any area is called electric flux. Mathematically, how to explain the electric flux? For uniform field, how to explain mathematically electric flux? For non-uniform field, how to explain the mathematical flux? Now, electric flux. Electric flux is represented by pi. Phi. The group of lines of forces, the bundle of lines of forces, whenever there is a charge, around the charge electric field. When the electric field is present, electric lines of forces are also present. Electric lines of forces are there, now electric flux also there. By using the concept electric flux, we can calculate electric field intensity at any point. We can calculate the potential at any point mathematically. Now, let us consider a surface. This is the surface. This is the surface. Any surface. An arbitrary surface. Whatever the total area of the surface. Now, let us consider there is a small area. This is a small area. The magnitude of the small area is represented by ds. Generally, area is a scalar quantity. But whenever you consider smaller areas, it may be treated as vector quantity. Whenever the vector quantity is there, it should have the direction. Whenever you consider a small area, whenever it is treated as a vector, we should assign a direction. The direction is an outward normal. This is the outward normal. This is the outward normal. This is called area direction. Area direction. Now this area is in a electric field. What is the strength of the electric field? Let us consider the strength of the electric field, E bar. At this point, the electric field is represented by E, and the direction of electric field intensity is like this. Then the angle between area vector to the electric field intensity is theta. Now, through the small area, electric flux can be defined as d phi is equals to the dot product between electric field intensity to the area vector. Now, there is a charge. Around the charge, there is an electric field. In the electric field, there are electric lines of forces. In that place, we can choose an arbitrary surface. Through the arbitrary surface, what is the total flux you want to define mathematically? For that one, choose a small area whose small area magnitude is a ds. This small area are treated as a vector quantity. We should assign a direction. That direction is outward normal. Now, at the point the small area is located, at that point the electric field intensity is represented by E bar. The angle between electric field intensity to the area direction is theta. Then the flux passing through the small area is defined as the dot product between electric field intensity to the area vector is called electric flux. Now, total flux I want to get. The total flux. The total flux can be had by integrating the above equation. Therefore, on integrating, on both sides, integration of d phi is equals to E dot ds. This integration is taking place closed integral. Now, integration is through a closed surface. Therefore, integration of d phi is equals to closed integral of E bar dot ds bar. Now, this is the equation for valid any closed surface. This equation is valid for any closed surface. Now, the phi may be written as closed integral of E, that is ds cos theta. Therefore, now this is the flux, total flux through any closed surface. Phi is equals to closed integral of E ds cos theta. But here, now, where ds bar is equals to ds into a unit vector. Ds bar is equals to ds into n cap. What is ds? Area magnitude. What is n cap? It is the unit vector of area. Thereby, ds bar is equals to ds into n cap.